Yomiyama, Aya, Jamal, what a man. Tonu,
Tonu, set up to look at the air. No more so worry.
Tyson get a neck on her hunky than which you are born.
What would you do if you could speak with the loved one just one more time after they had passed? I'm not talking about Ouija boards or Teresa Caputo's psychic powers on TLC. I'm talking about using modern day technology. Unbelievable, isn't it? Deep Brain AI wants to give us the option of living forever.
Wait, what?
Huh?
What?
It sounds crazy, it sounds nuts, but it's real. AI and death? What has the world come to? Are we taking artificial intelligence too far this time around? Let's break down exactly what Deep Brain AI is offering, and maybe you can decide for yourself. If you're ready, then I am. Let's dive in right away. The concept of communicating with the dead is nothing new. It dates back thousands of years. The fascination with reaching out beyond the grave has spawned several stories we know today. Late in 2022, Deep Brain AI, a South Korean company, launched a service that made even the most skeptical among us sit up and take notice. The service is called Rememory, and it allows you to have a conversation with your loved ones who've passed away. Yes, you heard right. You can talk to those who are no longer with us. If you're a fan of Black Mirror, you might recall an episode called Be Right Back, where Martha clones a version of her husband after he dies. Well, Rememory is eerily similar, but less creepy, at least for now. The AI-based service creates a digital twin of your loved one that synthesizes important features of theirs. From their voices, facial expressions, and even their mannerisms, the AI recreates a complete replica of them. The digital twin is the other version of them that will have conversations with you after they are long gone. The initial phase of creating this digital twin requires the participant to sit through an interview session and screening lasting about 7 hours, which is estimated to cost between $12,000 and $24,000. This is the building block phase, where the company tries to understand the individual's persona. The way you talk, how your lips move, and even how you tell jokes are all captured. Different modularities of AI are applied here, including generating text, speech synthesis to replicate your voice, and a visual output that can be rendered to appear very realistic. The company also keeps records of previous videos and personal stories of the loved one, which can be shared with family and friends after their death. So let's take a pause here. Tell me how you feel about this offering from Deep Brain AI. Death is obviously a very sensitive topic, and some believe the company may be taking advantage of people in vulnerable states. Others believe the company is offering a very valuable service that can reconnect individuals with their loved ones in times of grief or on anniversaries. I do have my reservations about the future implications of services like this, but I think I'm more pro than against it for now. The Rememory service provides a 30-minute experience reuniting you with your loved one and is set to cost about $1,200 for each visit. Obviously, one will need to make a certain minimum wage to even have access to this kind of service. Deep Brain AI has a memorial showroom where you can experience the service in private. They have a large 400-inch screen and a high-quality sound system to make your experience more realistic. With technology improving at an exponential rate over the years, it's easy to see how realistic this AI service can be in just a few years, especially with state-of-the-art virtual reality software on the horizon. You can talk to loved ones you miss so much, and it will feel like they never left. You can discuss new events happening in your life or revisit old memories, but there's a philosophical underpinning to this, the ship of thesis. I came across this thought experiment about 2 years ago. The thought experiment questions whether an object that has had all of its original components replaced remains the same object. A digital twin version of you isn't you, but in some sense it is. If Rememory talks with you the same way your loved one would have spoken with you, it offers advice when needed and criticizes when appropriate, then why is it such a bad thing? As with any other technology, our levels of acceptance and understanding of what reality is tend to be pushed even further. Art imitates life, but I think the opposite is also true. Life imitates art, especially with the advent of mind-blowing technology. The kind of tech we've seen in recent years is something we would only see in sci-fi movies. Deep Brain AI also has other digital twin applications of popular people, like the AI news anchor that has her AI counterpart reporting the news in a separate afternoon program.
어제 코로나19 확진자가 61명 나왔습니다.
But that's not all. They also have a digital version of the current South Korean president, which was used during the campaign stage to address voters. Are we witnessing the end of actual real human-to-human interactions? Well, only time will tell. But there's more. So, DeepBrain AI isn't the only company exploring the digital twin economy. Rumors recently spread like wildfire that Bruce Willis had sold the rights to his likeness to deepfake company Deepcake. This rumor was eventually debunked by Bruce's agent. The company had only worked with the actor on one ad campaign that uses AI version. Deepcake bills itself as a company that commercializes digital replicas across different domains, from ads to movies and everything in between. Synthesia is a similar company that allows you to create custom avatars with the goal of creating content without cameras, microphones, or even a studio. It's obvious to see that in the future, digital twins will be able to interact more naturally with people. AI-generated voices are getting incredibly good. I was recently impressed by this new AI company, 11 Labs. The company released AI voices, even with custom options, that sound so natural to the human ear. I uploaded a sample script from one of my previous videos to the website and oh my, it's really, really good. I used a generic AI voice, but the output is still very high quality. Check this out.
Some refer to it as the disruption of the fourth industrial revolution. Welcome to the age of AI.
In the future, actors, community leaders, and even politicians may be able to address different groups of people at the same time. What do you think about deepfakes, digital twins, and in particular, rememory? Would you sign up for this service? Let me know in the comments below because I'm dying to hear your thoughts. Rememory won the honorary award at the prestigious 2023 CES trade show, making it the second time in a row for the company. If you're not aware of CES, it's an annual trade show that typically hosts presentations of new technologies from some of the biggest and most innovative companies. Another AI application for immortality revealed at the trade show was Mindbank, a company that provides a platform for storing your digital replica through a simple chat interface and structured learning algorithms. How does Mindbank work? The app asks you questions and you just type your answers. It collects your thoughts and life story over time. This is what the company calls your conscious mind, giving you the ability to live forever through data. It allows your descendants to interact with you sometime in the future through regular chat. It seems the age of immortality is finally upon us. I expect to have more and more companies like this popping up in the future. You can see we've arrived at the wild, wild west of AI technology. It's a bit nerve-wracking watching some of the tech innovations come to life, but I guess we've already crossed the threshold of slowing things down and taking a breather. This is what some are calling the inflection point. Things are really, really about to take off. So let's take a break from talking about these AI replicas and check out some of the other fascinating presentations at CES 2023. One to make note of is Hey Mirror, a product that's here to revolutionize your everyday life. This display mirror is connected to the Internet of Things and can control your home cooling system and curtains in your bedroom, monitor your health and fitness, and much more. Hey Mirror uses advanced artificial intelligence to recognize your voice and detect movements while you exercise. It's a brilliant example of the kind of device that's made possible by the Internet of Things, where everything is interconnected. IoT applications have grown in popularity in recent years due to the convergence of devices that can send data to one another. But Hey Mirror is just one of many AI products on display here at CES 2023. Samsung's AI-powered television and oven are also taking center stage. The oven is especially intriguing. It has sensors that can recognize over 80 dishes and ingredients, and it can recommend meals based on what's in your pantry. It even sends warning signals when your food starts to burn, ensuring that your meals are always cooked to perfection. This is especially great for rookie chefs like me. And if you're curious, you can live stream your food as it cooks, making you the ultimate food influencer. And finally, there's a self-driving stroller which takes convenience to the next level. It's perfect for parents who want to spend time with their baby while also running errands. The stroller does all of the navigating while you get some fresh air and bond with your little one. We're living in pretty interesting times, and who knows what we'll see next. If you're as fascinated by all of this as I am, be sure to check out the channel for more updates on the latest AI developments. And if you want to stay ahead of the curve, then make sure you hit that subscribe button. Thanks for watching. Until the next video, it's goodbye.